Hi everyone, and welcome to the first video of this series on Django fundamentals. Okay, so let's go straight to it. Okay, so of course, let's just read a little bit about Django. So we can see this is at djangoproject.com. So basically, we can see here that Django is a high-level Python web framework, and we can see it encourages rapid development and clean, pragmatic design. And we could also see a few advantages of Django. We can see it is very fast, it is very secure, and it is scalable. So of course we can build a very simple web application with Django, and we can scale up to a rather larger and more complex one. Okay, so of course you can read more on this at the URL here. Also, before we get started, you must make sure that you have Python installed on your machine or your computer. So be sure to do that. Just for this purpose here of this video here, I am currently using Python 3.9.13. So of course, if you want to follow exactly with the version I'm using, you can see it just there. So make sure that you install Python. All right. Right, so let's get straight to it. So the first thing that we want to do is we want to get set up and install and set up everything for our Django project. Okay, so the first thing that I want us to do is to make sure that we install a virtual environment. Okay, so let's go to CMD. Okay, so here I'm on my CMD, and we're only going to use pip install virtual env, the command, once. Okay, so this will be globally on our system. So let's just say pip install virtual env. Okay, so what we're doing here is we're installing a package through the pip command. Okay, so and this package is for virtual environment, so virtual env. Okay, so just run that command in your CMD. Okay, so as I can see here, I already have it installed. So don't worry if you see a different message from mine. So just make sure that you install that. Okay, so we have that all set and ready to go. Now, what we're going to do is I like to always just create a folder or a directory on my desktop here. So I'm just going to right click and I'm just going to make a new folder. So I'm going to call this, let's call it development. Okay, and what we're going to do is we want to go into development. Now the development folder is on our desktop. So first we need to cd, which means change directory. So these are some, this is a basic CMD command. So I'm going to say here, I'm going to change to desktop. Then I want to go into my development folder, which is on my desktop here. Okay. So there we go. Now that we are in our desktop and in our folder development, we can now go ahead and create a virtual environment. Okay, so to do that, we will say virtual env, and then you want to give your virtual environment a name. So in this case, I'm going to call it venv. Okay, so you can give it any name that you like. So just press enter. And what will happen is, your virtual environment will be created. Okay, and this is the first step when working with our project. Okay, so I can see here. Okay, it's been created. Perfect. So now we can go ahead and activate our virtual environment. Now to do that, we need to say venv, or your custom name that you gave your virtual environment. And you need to say scripts backslash activate. And then we can see we are in our virtual environment and everything's looking perfect here. Now, if we want to deactivate our virtual environment, we would simply just say deactivate. Okay. Right, let's say we want to clear this up because it looks a little bit cluttered. We can just say CLS, which is a command to just clean this up. There we go. Right, so there are probably some of you wondering, like, what is a virtual environment? Like, what is that? So good question. So let's take a look here. So I've just created this sort of sketch here, so I'll zoom in a bit. Okay, so simply put, so a virtual environment is basically a tool that helps us to isolate our independent Django projects, we could say, with its own unique set of dependencies and packages. So basically, let's say we have a project one that is Facebook. We have another project that's Airbnb, and a third project, which is Uber. So basically, we have our own three projects, okay? And in each project, okay, we have created a virtual environment. So you can see here the orange. And of course, in this virtual environment, we have, for example, packages in these environments, okay? So for example, Facebook will use certain packages, Airbnb, other packages, Uber, other packages. Some will use the same, but of course, these are different applications, so they'll use their own dependencies and packages. Okay, so this is how I want you to try and understand it. Okay, so this is what a virtual environment is and how it works. Okay, so what we're going to do now is we're going to create our Django project. Okay, and then we're going to move on from there by testing our server and seeing if it works. But hopefully by now you understand basically what a virtual environment is, and let's go further. Right, so let's go back here. And what we're going to do is we are going to install Django. So first thing we want to do is we want to say our environment command. So that would be venv, and we're going to activate it. Activate. There we go. Now we can see it's activated. So if you see the custom name that you assigned your virtual environment, you'll see it here in parentheses. So what you can do now is you can go ahead and install Django. So remember, whenever you install a package, in other words, whenever you use pip, pretty much, to install a package, make sure that you're in your virtual environment. Okay, so this will all go to one project. So remember the analogy of Facebook, Twitter, Airbnb, Uber, it's all in that project. So make sure that your virtual environment is online. So everything goes to that environment, and it's not globally on your machine. It's in that specific directory here, development. Okay, so we're going to now install Django. So run the following command, pip install Django. Okay, so it shouldn't take too long. So let's just wait for that to finish up. Okay, it's going pretty fast. That's a good sign. Okay, so basically we're just installing Django here. And then what we're going to do is we're going to create a Django project. Okay, and this is all housed, and you could say protected within our virtual environment. Okay, so let's just wait for this here. Okay, so now we can see that Django has been installed. Okay, perfect. Next thing that we want to do, we want to clear this up. So remember CLS, just clean this up. And we want to actually create our Django project. So this is our actual project. So we need to run the following command, Django dash admin, then start project. And then the last parameter you could say is our project name. So give a name to your project. So in this case, I'm just going to call it, let me think of a name. So I'm just going to call it Taskly. Okay, so that's going to be the name of my project, Taskly. Okay, actually, let's change this name. Let's make it more interesting. Let's say, what can we call it? I'm going to call it Taskly. So give it any name that you want. So start project. Okay, there we go. So we want to now see our project now. So we can just minimize this. Let's go to our development folder. Okay, there we go. We can see our Django project here. Okay, we can see it here. And we can see some files, of course. Right, great. All right, so of course, one other thing that I should have mentioned. So make sure that you have an IDE. Okay, so for example, I am using Visual Studio Code. Okay, so of course, you can just go and search for that if you'd like. So this is what I'm using, VS Code. So a code editor, let me say that. So it's a code editor. So of course you can decide what you'd prefer to use. There are different ones, but I prefer Visual Studio Code. So if you want to follow what I'm doing exactly, just go ahead and download this. Of course I'm using Windows, so just remember to have that. Okay, very important. Right, okay, so just get back to it. Okay, there we go. Okay, so we've now created our Django project. And what I'm going to do is I am simply going to open this up. So let's go and do that. Okay, let's open it up. Okay, so in case you don't see your project opening up like mine, you can just simply go to File, Open Folder, and you just want to select your folder here, so your directory development. Okay, so mine's already open. Now remember what I said about the virtual environment? Okay, so it encapsulates our Django project per se. So make sure that you just move it into your Django project. So in this case, I called my Django project taskly. So just drag and move it here. Okay, just say yes. Okay, perfect. So it's now all housed together. Okay, so before we run and test our server, I just want to explain a few things here. So I'll be brief, but I think it's important that you understand what's going on here. So first of all, we have our manage.py file here. So basically, we use this to run management commands. We'll use it to run our development or dev server. We'll also use it to create migrations and do a lot more with it. So see it as our management sort of file for running management commands. Okay. Then we have, if we go into our project here for Django, you'll see that we sort of have two instances of our project. We have our folder here called Taskly, our Django project, and also another one here. So don't worry about that. Let's go to the second one here and let's go to settings.py. Now, of course, this here, okay, is our, probably our most important file here. Okay, so this pretty much is our project backbone and our configuration code. So we'll be using this file and referring to it a lot. Okay, so here we'll configure things called such as apps, also our database as well, as we see here, templates as well, static files, and a lot more. We'll also configure a lot of other settings as well. Okay, so that's settings.py. We also have urls.py. Okay, so this is basically for helping us to map our paths, our URL paths, and routes in our project. So this is for routing and creating paths here. This is basically for our URLs. Then we also have a wsgi.py file. So this stands for Web Server Gateway Interface. So basically, this is very important and useful for deployment. So just bear that in mind. We also have an asgi.py file. So basically, this stands for Asynchronous Server Gateway Interface. So basically, Django has inbuilt support, okay? And this is pretty new to Django, all right? But we don't need to know too much about this. Then we have an init.py file. Okay, this is an empty Python file, and you know, for learning the fundamentals of Django, this is not really necessary. So you don't need to worry about that. So while it's not good to worry, we have to focus on a few files here. So I only want you to worry about the manage.py file. Okay, and in our project files here, I want you to be aware of settings.py and urls.py for now. So just three files I want you to focus on. Don't worry about the rest. So manage.py, urls.py, and settings.py. Ignore the rest for now, since remember, we're just learning the fundamentals. Okay, so what we want to do now is run our server. So we are in our development folder, but we want to go into our project folder here, Taskly. So we can just go here, and we want to go to Taskly. Okay, that means we are over here in our project. And within Taskly, we have, of course, our project here as well, our virtual environment, and manage.py. So we want to run a command here with our manage.py file here. So we can just say Python manage.py. And this is how we would initiate, for example, a management command. Now, let's say we want to run our development server. We would just say run server. So Python manage.py run server. So let's press enter. Okay, and there we go. So we can now see that our development server is available at this URL here. And we have a few messages here about unapplied migrations, but not to worry about that. You may also have seen a SQLite database sort of file appear here, but don't worry about that for now. And a message about migrations and apps, but don't worry, we will cover that soon enough. So what I want you to do is just to focus on this URL. So just copy this here. And you can just paste that in here. And we can see here that Django has been installed and set up successfully. So if you see this message, like, well done, you've really got off to a great start. So well done. Okay. So basically, our server's online now, and if we want to stop it, we can just say Control C. Now you'll see it's offline. And if you were to refresh here, you'd see it would crash. Okay, so that's basically it. So this is installation and setup done. Okay, so I hope you learned something new.